do the journey that I think it was the people who were supposed to go to Easter Island did originally. I must have read that 400 times. Why? You know, but I loved it. Absolutely loved it. So, yeah, I mean, that was pivotal. James Bond, you know, on all the bestseller lists, and that was really pivotal. I mean, but it changed my worldview. And maybe not so much. I mean, I think, you know, it was a kind of an accumulation, really. You know, there was a book in America called A Wrinkle in Time, which nobody here reads, but everyone in America has read, and not just people my age, but, like, everybody living in America now. I mean, it's just one of those books that all kids read. It's never been out of print since 1960 when it was written. And that was pretty pivotal. I mean, that was, you know, sort of science fiction, fantasy, but a real book of ideas as well.
Do you find being a writer a lonely profession?
No. I mean, I'm 55. I wrote my first novel when I was 46, I think. And so I, you know, 25 years, I got up every morning and, you know, got dressed and went to an office, you know, got on the Northern Line. And, so no, I love it. You know, the longer I do it, the lonelier and stranger I get. But I mean, occasionally, like sometimes I'll be working away and the phone rings and it's my agent, and you can hear on the other end of the phone, you hear that slightly frightened sound in someone's voice where they realize you haven't talked to anyone all day. So yeah, I mean, sometimes you get a bit strange, but I don't get lonely now.